Today we're going to look at a fun and easy way to build yourself a rocket using PVC pipe, water, and a soda bottle. To get started, we'll need a length of 1/2 inch PVC pipe, 4 1/2 inch PVC pipe caps, 3 1/2 inch tees, and 1 piece of 1 1/4 inch pipe, about 2 inches long. We'll want a pipe cutter, a saw, or some way to cut the PVC. This is what we've got in mind. We'll build a frame and latch system out of our PVC pipe, fill a soda bottle a little bit with water, and then add pressure. Once it's where we want it, we pull a string and let it fly. First off, just a quick test. We want our soda bottle to just barely fit over the PVC pipe, and with 1/2 inch PVC, that's what it should do. First up, we want to cut off a piece just over 1 foot long. I'm going to go for about 13 inches. This is the first piece of our launch setup, and this is what's going to fit inside of our soda bottle, which will be turned into our rocket. We now need to build a frame, and it's going to be sort of H-shaped, with this piece coming right out of the center of the H. Let's cut 2 pieces that are 10 inches long and 4 pieces that are 6 inches long. We want to attach a T onto the bottom of this first piece. We'll have 2 pieces coming off of either side. Those will each end in a T shape, and then we'll have arms coming off of each of those spots, with each of those 4 arms covered with a cap. And with that, we have the basic frame for our rocket launcher. It's pretty stable. It doesn't twist either direction. Of course, right now it's not held together with anything but a little bit of friction, so it does collapse. We'll be using glue once we're ready though. Our soda bottle, which we're gonna fill with water, wants to fit down onto this launcher about 2/3 of the way up the bottle. Just mark that point. So that's about how far down we want the neck, the bottom of our bottle. As a launching mechanism, we're going to be using a bunch of zip ties. These things are durable, they're springy, and they're cheap, which makes them a great tool. We want 8 of these. 8, there's 8. These are going to be held in place with a pipe clamp. We're just gonna take that, and right now, we're going to drop that down onto our pipe. We wanna be able to take all 8 of these zip ties and space them just right evenly all the way around this pipe. To do that, let's take a piece of duct tape, wrap that all the way around the pipe, and then mark where it starts and finishes so we can line all of our zip ties up against the tape. We're going to leave about 3.5 inches of our zip tie above the tape. And you can see that on one side of the zip tie, the head is just flat, and on the other side, it's a bump. And we want the bump to be sticking up towards us and the flat side to be attached to the tape. There we go, that's much better. We've got almost a perfectly even distribution all the way around. It's gonna be off by a little bit here and there, and that's not a problem. We just wanna try and make it as evenly spread as we can. Let's just trim off the bottom of all 8 zip ties right below our tape. Now we need our soda bottle down in place. We've already measured that. And we want these zip ties to be lined up so they are right above the widest lip on our bottle. Not these little bumps that are the threads for putting the cap on, but this collar around the neck. We want our zip ties to fit right above that. With the tape on there, it actually doesn't really stick too much because there's so many zip ties in the way that the tape isn't touching the PVC. But that's all right, it lets us make sure we've got our alignment just right. Put the bottle where we want it, check the zip ties. This is why we want our hose clamp. This is gonna squeeze down and really hold all of those zip tie pieces in place. There we go, now our zip ties aren't going anywhere. You can already see that they can get a pretty good grip on the bottle. To get an idea of how this mechanism is gonna work, our 1 1/4 inch piece of PVC pipe, we can fit right down over those zip ties. When we drop our bottle down into place and lift this portion of PVC, it holds all of the zip ties in place. They can't move away anymore, and so now they're holding that bottle right where we want it. And even if you add a lot of pressure pulling it up, it's not gonna go anywhere until we drop down this collar and set it loose. One more thing we do want to do is that our bottle does fit pretty nicely right over the PVC, but it's not a perfect fit. And it doesn't need to be 100% perfect, but we do want a little bit tighter than it is now. We're gonna use some electrical tape, wrap it around this PVC post, and that will create a seal that is water and airtight, or at least pretty close, that will hold while we add pressure to our bottle. I'm just marking where all of our zip ties reach to right now, because this step, while it may not always be technically necessary, I think helps. So I'm just going to loosen our hose clamp a little bit now that we've seen how these are going to work. I'm going to drop them down out of the way. This line here represents where our water bottle neck will reach, and so we're going to start about halfway over that line. We're going to pull this electrical tape nice and tight, so it's a very thin barrier. We're just going to wrap it around a few times. I'm taking the bottle and I'm pressing it down, and it's actually just smooshing that electrical tape. And that's just going to build up into sort of a ring. That ring is what's going to hold all of the water and compressed air back as we add pressure into our bottle. Now we need to take one of our caps and add a Schrader valve into it. That's the same kind you see on a bicycle tire. And that's how we're going to add pressure into the whole system. We've got a 1/2-inch drill bit. Drill a hole right into one of our caps. Schrader valve stuck through, and now we need to pull it. There we go, until it seats itself. There's a groove in the valve, and that's what we want to sit right along the edge of where we drilled the hole. At this point, we need to take some PVC glue and attach all of our pieces together permanently, making sure that we have enough glue and they're really well attached so that no air will leak out. That glue does need to dry all the way before we start doing any pressure testing on it, but while it's drying, I think this is gonna be a good time to add some decoration, because we love decoration. Now, we do like decoration on all parts of the launcher. However, the top part of this post really needs to be pretty smooth so that our bottle will launch off of it the way we want. And we don't really want to get paint all over all the moving parts, the zip tie pieces that are going to be holding stuff together. So this top post will just be the color it is. We've also taped off the Schrader valve because we don't want to get that plugged up. The rest of it though, let's make it a little more interesting. Now that everything is decorated, we can move on to adding a little bit of a spring system. Now this pipe is what's gonna hold all of these zip ties closed, but it's gravity is currently pulling it down. We want it to stay up so that it holds our bottle locked in place until we pull down on it. So to make that spring, we're just gonna use a couple more zip ties. We're gonna attach them around this tube and around this T-joint, and that should give us the spring that we need to hold it in place. I think it's time for a quick test with no water in our bottle and very low pressure. This is just to see how everything's working out so far. It is still really low pressure though. It hasn't even hit like 10 PSI. Woo! Tiny delay in taking off, but that hit my hand with some good power. So this is working out nicely. We've got this all painted up, and we need to be able to pull this down from a little bit of a distance so that we're not just like always getting soaked every time we launch this. Plus it's harder to watch if we're right here, or they're firing. So we need to attach some cord onto here and make it so we can pull from the side and have it drop this down. So we're gonna over-engineer this just a little bit. We're going to attach two of these eye hooks down into the PVC, and they're gonna be drilled and then threaded in, and we're gonna add some epoxy just to make sure that we keep our airtight seal through all of the pipes. Then we're gonna have cord attached to the side of the PVC coming down through the eye hooks and connecting in the front, so when we pull forward, it will pull down on our trigger mechanism. Our launcher is now built. It should be complete and working well, so what we need now is to turn our bottle into a rocket. And there's lots of different ways we can do that. Today, we're just gonna use a little bit of craft foam and duct tape to add a cone on the front and some fins on the sides. I'd say that works, and it's time to start filling this with water. Take it to somewhere like a field instead of, inside. See what it can do. We've got our launcher, we've got our rocket, and I'm just gonna use some of these little garden stakes to make sure that it holds the launcher down. And I can already pull on this and trigger it pretty well, but you know, if I pull too hard, I don't want it to tip and then shoot the rocket off whatever angle. We now want to fill our rocket partially with water, and I say partially because it kind of ends up being a little bit different every time. Sometimes you want about 1/3 full, sometimes 1/2 full, and we'll have to do some experimentation to figure out. All right, I'm just gonna try and pop this on as quickly as I can to avoid spilling too much water down the tube. That worked all right. Now there may even be a little bit of leaking down at the seal and more once I start adding pressure, but it's gonna be minute, it won't be severe, and it should still work pretty well, even though it's gonna, I don't think it's leaking at the moment, but it probably will once I start adding pressure. Just little bits trying to escape out that seal between the water bottle and the tape around the PVC pipe. All right, let's add some pressure and see how this goes. Yep. Oh! Oh, I think it popped off our lock a little bit. And when I say a little bit, I mean completely, because obviously it just popped right off. It may be that we just need to add two more zip ties on the sides to give some extra push up on this. All right, we've got more zip ties adding pressure. Let's see if that actually increases how much we can put in.
3, 2, 1.
More pressure.
Random fact, the fastest rocket record was set by the Atlas V in 2006, which reached a top speed of 47,000 miles per hour, or about 76,000 kilometers per hour.
There might be a little bit of water in the system. 3, 2, 1. Oh, almost had it. So I think so far we've had a lot of good launches. Our best ones probably went about 100 feet up, which is not bad for a soda bottle and some PVC powered by a bike pump. We do have one more thing we want to try with this, and that's to see what happens if we use a little bit more luminescent fluid than water. All right, guys, now it's nighttime, and we have two jars full of the two different components of glow fluid, one of which is slightly glowing already because of an inadvertent break in the glass as I was emptying them out. However, we'll add some fuel and we'll see if we can get this to launch with glowing fuel the color of like rocket fire flying out the back of this. I hope it works out. We kind of only have one shot because do you know how many glow sticks you have to get for this much liquid? This is like 60 glow sticks right here, and they're big glow sticks too. Maybe more. It might be as much as 100. I wasn't counting too carefully, but there's a lot. And so yeah, we get about one shot with this. Got my super fancy high quality funnel that I made out of duct tape. All right, I'm gonna add soap, swirl it around, and then load it up. Ultra bright. All right. Starting to leak. 3, 2, 1. Woo! Yeah! Oh, that poor bike pump. That poor everything. Well, there's our spent rocket. Little residual glow fluid coming out there. I mean, rocket fuel coming out there. That'll look great. We've got a couple of cool swirl patterns here. I think maybe it spun as it went out or something. I'm not really sure. But we've got like a swirl arm that reaches around that way, and then another one coming out this direction. And you can just see the whole spray pattern everywhere. The whole project is quick. It's cheap. It goes together easily. This is a great thing to do with young kids because it's just water spraying out of a bottle. It's gonna be a lot of fun. Guys, thanks for watching, but that's not all. We've got more for you to see. That box up at the top will transport you directly to our last video, and you should go check that out. The other box will show you what YouTube thinks you should be watching next. And if you aren't a subscriber, just hit this bomb to get in the club, and that way you never miss out on a cool video. Don't forget to ring that bell, and we will see you in the next one. Talk to you then.